G'day folks, Rod from My Water Filter here today. And what we're gonna do is have a look at the high performance filtration undersink reverse osmosis systems, okay? Now, these here are absolute beauties, all right? There's no ifs or buts about that, regardless of what's going on. Nowadays in our capital cities, the water quality is deteriorating, there's no doubt about that. And these systems here certainly will get all of that garbage out of the water. The cartridge replacements on these type of systems are generally fairly cheap and a good economical price for a family or normal people to be able to afford, run and use. And there's no doubt about it, with the waste component, obviously they have a wastewater component, they do split the water and they do provide a very good quality water, all right? Definitely a step up from a normal undersink mechanical filtration system, all right? As you can see, they've got a range of systems. The reason for that being, different people in society require different water needs, okay? Now, what I would suggest to everybody is if you're just a normal person and you're reasonably fit and healthy, here is a four-stage reverse osmosis water filter, okay? Now, this is it. This is all you need, really, okay? So, on these systems here, the water comes in and it goes through the bottom housing here, and it's a sediment cartridge, all right? It's just taking the dirt, the sediment, the lumps and bumps out of the water. All of these systems are the same on the bottom. We're gonna take the sediment out. Once we've done that, the water flows over into this second cartridge, the second housing. Now, you'll see that most water filters have just got a carbon cartridge here in this position, right? And generally that's okay. But what's happening now, especially the east coast of Australia, there's a lot of chloramine being used to disinfect the water rather than the chlorine. Now, if you want to make sure you're getting that chemical and chloramine out, that's where these systems are great, because they've put a chloramine removal cartridge, which will remove chlorine as well, into this second housing, okay? And you won't see that on most ROs, but this one here has got it, and it is good for the east coast of Australia, all of Australia, because it'll take out the chlorine as well, but chloramine is an issue nowadays. So these two cartridges here, sediment, dirt, chemicals, chlorine, chloramine out of the water, protecting the membrane, which is the big system here through the middle, and this is the actual membrane that goes inside these housings, okay? This is the main powerhouse of any reverse osmosis system. This is the one doing the damage. Splitting the molecules, all the large molecules out the waste, and the pure water molecules are going to collect in that tank up there. So that's the setup there. Once the water's been filtered, so as I said, all these three systems, they're all exactly the same, and they've all got these three cartridges in them, cartridge membrane in them. That is the filtration component of these systems. That's generally the filtration component of just about any RO system, is the first three or four stages. After the membrane, the filtration's done, okay? And that is how you pick a good RO, or you pick an RO suitable for your situation, in that what the reverse osmosis filter is going to do for your water after the filtration's over. Now, that's why I say this one is a beauty. Cheap, plain and simple, and good for all of Australia. On the top here is just an inline cartridge, and the sole purpose of this cartridge is to add some mineral into the water and elevate the pH back up to around the neutral 7 mark, okay? Because when this reverse osmosis membrane splits and strips the water, it's taken all the mineral, it's taken everything out of the water, all right? You're almost starting from base water again. So here we are, taking everything out, and the pH of the water is going to be around the 6 mark. Obviously depends on your income and water supply pH, but generally it's going to be 6 pH after these membranes filter all the water. Then we've got to get it back up to 7. We want to be drinking 7 pH, human beings. So this cartridge here is a neutralizer, add some mineral, elevate the water up, give or take a bit different water qualities, but this system, the 4th stage, is going to be produced around the 7 pH water mark, all right? That's perfect, that's beautiful, that's where you want to be, okay? Not acidic rainwater, not high alkaline water, normal health, normal human being, around the 7 pH, or just above 7 pH water, and you're good to go, okay? Then, if you've got desires for a pH level above for what the 4th stage can do, above 7 pH, you might want to take a look at this five stage, all right? It's a beauty, don't get me wrong, but this is going to elevate the pH of the water right up, more like probably 9, and then as the alkalizer cartridge wears down in time, we'll start coming back to about an 8 pH, something like that. But be aware that that's what this is for, is to create higher pH water, okay? And same again, the membrane is here. After the water comes out of the membrane, it collects in the tank. When you hit your faucet on the sink to get water, the water's coming out of the tank. It goes through the alkalizer, picking up mineral, elevating the pH. It goes through coconut carbon, and it's beautiful for making the water nice and sweet before you drink it. It'll make very tasty water, this I promise. The water will flow out of there up to your faucet and you're good to go, okay? Then we take a look at the seven stage, okay? Obviously, the best of the lot, but the situation here is, this system's creating high pH water, okay? I've got no dramas with anyone going with this system. I've used it myself, and it makes beautiful water, absolute beautiful water this will make from just government chlorinated city water. This will make magnificent quality water and very, very tasty, okay? Same as these two, filtration's on the bottom. After the filtration, everything above is what we're going to be using to elevate the pH and make the water suitable for us to drink again. So on this one here, the water comes out of the membrane and it goes straight through this T300 cartridge and collects in the tank, okay? So this elevates the pH of the water. This water here, especially when it's new, it's going to be anywhere up to 10 pH, 9.5 pH. This thing will make high pH water, okay? And it'll hold it for a long time, probably right through the whole year at least, okay? It'll hold a high pH water. So you'll get people, cancer, illnesses, something wrong with them, and the naturopaths, doctors, etc., send it to us for the high pH water. Well, this is a machine for that because it's got very good filtration to get all the garbage out, fluoride included, and then after that, above that, we tidy up the water. High pH, this one here, this is the far infrared beads, okay? So there's all beads inside this, interact with the water, far infrared, stops acidity in the body, there's a massive list we can go on. It's all on the website, so you can just have a look at that cartridge and what it does. After all of that action, we run it through some carbon, all right? Carbon's just a beautiful way to polish up the water, just make it the best for you that it can. So we're running the water through this carbon cartridge at the end, to polish it up, comes along, and then it goes through a negative magnet. So this magnet is a negative charge magnet, it's putting negative charge on the water. Us human beings like that, and it reacts very well. And the water flowing out of this water filter here is magnificent water. I can't question that. It is absolutely amazing. But just make sure you want high alkaline water if you're going for this system. A bit lower alkaline water without the magnet, without the far infrared beads, cheaper to run. And then just normal instances here, any house in Australia will have magnificent water flowing out with this one here. And I do highly recommend it, okay? Just quickly, comes with all the instructions. You've got a bag of parts. It's all color-coded so you know where the hoses go, things like that. Tap for the top of the RO tap, T-piece for under the sink. You've got the housing tool to take these housings off. Also the other one that slips inside that, take the end off the membrane when it's time to change the membrane. Bit of a cable cutter inside there, that's the red component that you can see there for cutting the hoses when you need to. The drain clamp that goes under the sink for the wastewater. Bit of thread tape in there for covering the any threads and things like that as we're putting it together. Tape up the T-piece when you're putting it together. Here's the faucet, and just a nice neat little faucet that comes with these systems. Pretty plain and standard, but neat, shiny chrome, and good to go. And as always, there's the instructions, there's the high performance warranty and general warranty. It's all there for you, so take a look. Have a look on the site here, and if we can help in any way, yell out, we'd love to chat to you. But these systems here, good quality, made here in Australia, got the Australian watermark on them, and I think that you will put this under your sink and you'll never have to look back. There'll be no repairs or anything to do, they'll just work and they're good to go, and the cartridge replacement is pretty cheap on them as well. So good luck, help in any way, yell out, but if you want an RO, these are a beauty. Thanks very much.